This is part two of simplifying fractions. And in the first part, I showed you one way of simplifying is trying to think of a number that goes into both the numerator and denominator, and then I go ahead and dividing the top and bottom by that number. Well, here's an example, 58 over 145, where it's not obvious to me what the common factor is in the numerator and denominator, but in fact, this is not simplified. So the other method I went over was prime factoring each number. So let's do that. 58, if you find the prime factorization, it's even, so you know it's 2 times something, and in fact it's 2 times 29. So this is 2 times 29, and then we have to do 145. Now, that ends in 5, so I know 5 goes into it, so I divide 145 by 5, and hey, lo and behold, it's 29. So this is 5 times 29. And then I see actually it does have a common factor of 29. So there's an example where it's easier to do the prime factorization to see how to reduce it, as opposed to racking your brain trying to think of what number goes into both 58 and 145. Which you can do. You could say, well, does 2 go into both numbers? Does 3 go into both numbers? Does 5? Does 7? Does 11? Try every prime number, but, you know, it's a long way till you finally ask yourself, does 29 go into both numbers? And then you probably wouldn't know that in the top of your head anyway. All right, so there's the beauty of prime factorization if you're not sure. All right, here's another fraction we have to simplify. Now, you could go ahead and do prime factorization, or maybe you might want to just start reducing it because they're both even. It's really up to you. So I'm going to do this a different way. I see they're both even, so I'm going to go ahead and divide them both by 2. So if I divide the top by 2, I get 96, and if I divide the bottom by 2, I have 134. And they're both even, so I'm going to divide by 2 again. 48. And let's see, how many times that go into it? I think it's 67. Well, at this point, they're not both even, and in fact, 67 is prime. So if one of the numbers is prime, and it doesn't go into the other number, or the other number doesn't go into it evenly, then you've got a reduced fraction. So this is now reduced. Now, if you had wanted to write the prime factorization, you could have done that as well. So you could have taken 192 and just started thinking of any numbers that go into it. And again, to me, it was easier just to do 2 times 96. And then 96, I'm going to do that as 2 times 48. And then you can do 8 times 6 and 4 times 2 and 2 times 2. There are a lot of steps here to prime factoring. So you could have gone ahead and just crunched it out and said, well, the prime factorization, be careful, you have all these 2s. So I've got how many 2s here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 factors of 2. And I have this 3. Then I could have done the same thing for 134. I could have prime factored that. And I see it is even, so I'm going to do 1/3, we wouldn't be factoring 134, we would be factoring the 268. So I'd start out with 134 times 2, and then I'm going to factor 134, which is going to be 2 times 67, which is prime. And so I could have written that, 2 times 2 times 67, and then you could cancel out the common factors. Now, what's nice about this method is when you get to algebra, when you're working with variables, it's easier to write out the prime factorization this way when you're working with variables. So it gives you a little practice. Then what we would have to do is go back and multiply these numbers together. So what's left at the top? I've got it 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 factors of 2, that's 16 times 3. That gives you 48 in the numerator, and in the denominator, all I have is 67. Notice you get the same answer. So two completely different methods, both resulting in the correct answer of 48/67. All right, let's see if you could do this one. I'm going to give you a hint. I think it's going to be easier to prime factor it using your divisibility test or a calculator. So put it on pause and try it. All right, it's not obvious to me what number goes into both of those at all. So I'm going to do this by prime factorization. 68 is even, so I'm going to write that as 2 times 34. And then 34 is even, so I'm going to write that as 17 times 2. And now there's my prime factorization. So I have 2 times 2 times 17. All right, now we have to do 119. And you know, by the way, this is sort of a hint. If you get 17 in one number, you wonder if maybe that's it. And in fact, it is going to be it here. But we just start off trying to figure out what number goes into 119. So we start with the prime numbers. Does 2 go into it? No. Does 3? No, because when you add the digit, you get 11, and 3 does not go into 11. Next prime number is 5. Doesn't end in 0 or 5. The next number is 7. Well, does 7 go into both of those numbers? Now, you can get a calculator and check it out. And in fact, 7 does go into 119. Or do you remember the rule, the divisibility test for, if you don't have a calculator handy, you could cross off that last digit, the ones digit, and you subtract, you multiply it by 2 and subtract. And then if you're subtracting a smaller number, just subtract the other way. 18 minus 11 is 7, and 7 goes into 7. So this is divisible by 7, but you will need to now figure out how many times 7 goes in there, and it goes in 17 times. So now you look and see, it's obvious to see the common factors. So your final answer, you're going to multiply the 2 times 2, which is 4 sevenths. And that's the reduced answer. Here are two fractions for you to try. See if you could simplify this, each of these problems. Okay, so let's do the first one. Now, if you know what number goes into both of those, you go ahead and divide, or you might just want to prime factor. So it's easy to prime factor 49. It's 7 times 7. So think about it this way. If anything's going to cancel, it's going to have to be a 7 because that's the only thing in the numerator can cancel. So I think 7 must be a factor of 126. So you can go over here and do that. See if it is. And if it's not, then it really doesn't matter what it prime factors to because you won't be able to cancel anyway. So I have 7 times 18. That's not the prime factorization, is it? But you can just write 7 times 18. So you can cancel the sevens. Now you could have kept going and you could have done 18 as 2 times 3 times 3, but in the end you'd have to multiply it out again. So what's left here is 7/18. Now you could have done this by prime factorization as well. All right, let's do this one. Again, if something's easy to prime factor, go ahead and do it that way. So 39 is 3 times 13. And so now looking at this other number, if anything cancels, it will have to be a 3 or a 13. So let's see, does 3 go into 104? No, because if you add the digits, you get 5. So probably 13 goes into it, but I don't know how many times. So I'm going to do this by prime factorization. It seems easier. 2 times 52, and then that's 26 times 2. And then that's 2 times 13. So I do see that 13 finally. So I have 3 factors of 2 times 13. So I have 2 times 2 times 2 times 13. And then I could cancel the 13s. And what do I have left in the top? Just the 3. And in the bottom, I've got 8. Now, what you have to be careful is if you cancel everything out of the numerator or the denominator, that means there's really a factor of 1. So let's do one like that. Right, let's say you're asked to simplify 6/18 by prime factorization. You would have 2 times 3 for 6. And in the denominator, that's 2 times 9, which is 2 times 3 times 3. So let's say you were doing prime factorization and then canceling. And you say, oh, there's nothing left in the denominator. You know what? There's always a factor of 1. You could always put a 1 up there to remind yourself. Don't ever just leave it blank or put a 0. And in the denominator, there's a 3. So this reduces to 1/3. That's very tricky. Now, if the ones in the denominator, for instance, if it was four halves and you did the same thing, you canceled. Well, it's true you could write 2 over 1, but 2 over 1 is always just 2. So in the denominator, if you leave it off, it kind of works out in the end, but it's because when you divide by 1, you just get the numerator. But in the denominator, a common mistake is to write an answer of 3 instead of 1/3. So watch out.